Welcome back to part 4 of our 100% walkthrough of Doom 2016, where we're going to complete all the mission challenges, rune trials, as well as find all secrets, collectibles, field drones, argent cells and elite guards. Also upgrading as much as we can along the way. In this mission we have to find 5 secrets, 4 elite guards, 2 field drones, 1 argent cell and complete 2 rune trials. And the challenges we got are walk the path, interact with a rune trial stone, bird's eye view, acquire the auto map for the Argent facility, and lastly, to be knighted, perform 2 death from above glory kills on Hell Knights.
Olivia is using the tower to drill a doorway into their world. You can prevent her from opening the gate by disabling the tower induction filters.
Untethered cross-dimensional activity is a frequent occurrence outside of the base, so it is recommended that workers buddy up when journeying onto the Martian surface.
Now, just as we jump across here, turn this corner, there's a rune trial. One of our challenges is to interact with this. So that's one of our challenges achieved. One of the achievements we can get is to win a rune stone. So just nail these suckers and you'll get an achievement at the end of it. With that rune trial complete, we can run up these stairs. We'll find a data log on the floor. Just to our left we'll find the lever for the secret doom room, so remember to give that a tug. Now, as we make our way down this corridor, we're going to turn to our right, and there's the secret doom room. I think you need to enter this. I'm not sure if it's one of our secrets, but pop in it inside anyway. If it's not, brilliant. It didn't come up as a secret on my map, but I'm not too sure. Okay, so in this next section we're going to come across lots of demons. Just kill them all, don't mess about. We want to just clear this area as quick as possible. You will, towards the end of this, come across our first Hell Knight. I'm not going to attempt to carry out a death from above curb stomp on him. What I'm going to do is leave it until later on when we've got our second rune stone, which is Days of Confused, and it will help to actually kill, well, to keep the Hell Knights in glory state mode a little bit longer, it'll be a lot easier for us. So just wipe these guys out and let's get on with the map. Okay, so this is our first Hell Knight. I'm just going to kill him. As I say, there is an easier way of completing our challenge on these guys, the Death from Above curb stomp. So just waste this guy and we'll get on with the map. Okay, now we're gonna follow this round here, jump up on this ledge and find our first elite guard. Pull the chip from his chest, upgrade your weapons, your suit, anything else you can upgrade. Just around this corner, that's our first gore nest. Now don't rip the heart out of it yet. What you need to do is just clear this area of as many of these demons as you can. Now that we've cleared out that particular area there, follow this round and pick up our Argent Cell. Now we're going to make our way to our second runestone trial of the map. It's the runestone Dazed and Confused. We need to get it. It will keep the Hell Knights in a state of glory kill for longer, giving us much more time to jump up on something and kill them. So we do need to get this runestone. Now that we have that runestone, you've got to go into your inventory and equip it in the only available space for the runestones. Remember, you have to equip it for it to work.
We're only temporarily disabling the tower. You need to remove each lens individually. Carefully release the hinge.
Contamination detected.
Destroying the production of Argent energy isn't necessary.
Okay, the first thing we're going to do is clear out as many of these demons as we can. Ripping the heart out of that gore nest has spawned a lot more demons, so again, we want to just clear them out. Don't go near the Hell Knight, just stay away from him. He's that big ugly dude there. One that's, I don't know, not half gorilla or something with a bald head. So clear these guys out, and then what we're going to do is we're going to lead him off into a little room where we can work on him privately. Kind of a private session. So just keep clearing these dudes out. Grab this shield, that will give us a little bit of armor, that will help. There's also some health if you need it, and we're going to let him, we're going to make him follow us into this room. See that box? We're going to need to jump on that box to complete the death from above glory kill, mainly because he's so tall. So just gently work on him, don't be a bit careful what you're firing at him. If these guys come in, kill them, they will only get in the way. Remember, just keep away from him while you're dealing with them. Now, we got him to ourselves, so there he is, he's in a state of glory kill, up on the box, so I left it a little bit too long now. There is a very short window to complete this challenge. So just keep working on him again. Keeping him close to the box, there we go, this one I completed. And that is the first of the two we got to do. So let's get out, find the other one. Ah, he's already joined the party. Get him to follow us back in here. And again, just gently work on him. Few rounds, keeping out of his way. He's got no weapons, what he does is just tries to squash you. So just keep working on him nicely. Be careful with the plasma rifle, you don't want to hit him too many times, it'll kill him. There you go, that's it. Now, again, and that's the challenge complete. Kill these dudes. To do the glory kill on these Hell Knights, you need to be above them, standing on a box, a crate or anything. You jump up in the air, you look at them, jump in the air and press the glory kill button, and that will complete the glory kill. Okay, now we're going to collect our field drone. So we're going to just jump down here, follow it around under this door, up here and to our left, collect our field drone. Next thing we need to do is find our elite guard, so just follow this path down here. There's three demons, they won't put up much of a resistance, and we'll get our elite guard at the end of it.
The hell energy is unusable without the filters.
Warning.
What you are destroying is more valuable than you can possibly imagine. It is a perfect and unlimited energy resource.
Okay, while we've got the dazed and confused runestone equipped, we may as well upgrade it, and we do that by carrying out 25 death from above glory kills, which is what I'm going to be doing whenever possible. That's 4 of 25. This would be 5 of 25 if I can get it. Yep, there's 5 of 25. So that's what I'm going to do whenever possible now, just to upgrade that stone. Remember to pick up this data log. And now we're going to make our way to a secret and our first collectible. Okay, ripping the heart out will spawn more Hell Knights. So what we're going to do is we're going to clear out as many of these guys as we can. Hopefully we'll clear all of them out. And then, that will allow us to work on the Hell Knights at our leisure. Okay, so we're near enough ready to kill this guy. What we're going to do is we're going to keep him over by these cartons here. Just keep running around these cartons, laying into him as much as we can, just a little bit at a time, until we get him in glory state. Then we're going to jump up on those cartons and we're going to finish him off. So there we go. I think actually that was just a little bit too far from the cartons here. Not to worry, we'll get him again. So just keep pumping shots. That's it, that's the one there. So, oh, good grief, I am playing with this guy. I don't know what I'm doing. Right, let's go for this again. There he is. Okay, we've got a big jump this time to get on top of him. And that's it. So that's another death from above on a Hell Knight. Here's the next one, and it's the same procedure. Okay, now we need to jump up here, and this is our next elite guard, so pull the chip from his chest. Okay, in this next area you're going to find a lot of demons. If you do it right, you should be able to upgrade your runestone. The best way to do that is to use the whole area. just keep moving around, and they, as they approach you, you can get them on their own one at a time and upgrade your rune stone in this area itself. I'm not going to worry about doing that because I want to keep this video fairly short. I don't want to take ages here. So I suggest you do that. I'm just going to get on and just clear the room as quick as possible. Okay, now we've cleared the room, we can run up here, and just around this corner on the desk is another data pad, data log, and behind us should be there a field drone. Okay, so there, oh there we go, we haven't cleared the room properly, it'd be why. Now that we've cleared the room now, there should appear a field drone. Just turn away from it, or you can leave the room if it doesn't appear. And there it is, brilliant. So get whatever upgrade you need. Now we're going to make our way to our next secret and collectible. Just carefully walk along this ledge, follow it round, it will take us into a secret area or a secret, and at the same time we'll get the collectible at the end. Okay, that's the door we want to go through. Before we do that, we're going to follow this little path down here to, again, another secret. And we'll also get the super shotgun. Now what I'm going to do here is, we want to just rip the heart out of this gore nest, then run over to this lift here, and just above it, right there, grab that power up, because remember we're trying to get the achievement juicing it up, which requires us to kill 150 enemies using a power up. Now this power up is haste, it's useless really, I don't know why they stuck it in there. And I only killed about four demons with it, but every little helps, I guess. Well, we're upgrading the rune stone. 21 of 25 now. Right, so we're going to make our way into this room. We're going to find the auto map at the other end. It's also a secret. And that is all three of our challenges now complete. Walk the path to be knighted and a bird's eye view. So we can generally get on with just upgrading whatever we need to upgrade now and not worry about the challenges at all. Now we need to collect this data log. There's some more ammo here. Destroy the filter.
Warning. Energy contamination at critical levels.
Okay, as we make our way out of this room, there's a new demon we come across. That's her there. I don't know what she's called, but if you stay in the doorway of this room, you're quite well protected, and sooner or later she will come towards you close to this doorway, and you'll be able to shoot a few rounds into her, get her into glory kill, there you go, so get her into glory kill state, that's it, do the glory kill, and that counts towards our rip and tear achievement. The rip and tear achievement, remember, is to carry out glory kills on every different type of demon. Okay, this is our last gore nest. And it's near enough the end of this map. So what you need to do is ensure... Well, it's not important, but really and truly you should upgrade that runestone by now. Or just try and upgrade it. Get it as far as you can at least. If you should have upgraded it by now. It shouldn't be a problem. So we're going to clear these guys out. There is a berserker over there. We're not going to use that yet because there's a couple of there's a hell knight and a couple of other big demons that we're going to use that on. So clear the room out, rip the heart out of that nest right there. If you still need to upgrade your runestone, then just keep away from these other demons and work on the smaller ones to do so. This is the last one I have to kill now, and I would have upgraded it, and that's it there. There's the upgrade done. So I'm going to grab that berserker and work towards the other achievement of juicing it up and just kill whatever I can. Okay, so we're going to carry on through the map. Instead of turning right, turn left here. That's our last elite guard. Now you need to check that you have all the challenges complete. You've collected everything there is to collect. You've done the rune trials, because we're at the point of no return here. The minute we go through that next door, we cannot return. So if you've got anything missing, do not press that button and go through this door.
If stopping our energy production is what you want, then you need only to destroy this last filter, and Argent energy will no longer exist in this solar system. We will be back at square one. You have no idea what you have just done.
Olivia is still alive. I've detected her life signature at the Argent Tower. She has removed one of the accumulators from the tower base. It has a unique energy signature that we can track.
Well, that's it then. There's nothing else to be done.